Red Wings fans, stand up. Yeah, we gonna throw them wings up,
wings up, wings up.
Show the league that this is our time. Let's make the city proud. We gonna win the Stanley Cup,
Stanley Cup, Stanley Cup.
After that, we gonna party. We go show everybody. We show them all around the world.
We show them all around the world.
We show them all around the world. We gonna throw them wings up. We gonna throw them wings up.
The Eastern Conference 6-1-1. It goes against average under 2 as we are underway from Pepsi Center as Detroit wins the opening draw and Mike Rain tries to get it down deep with 34. 14 of those 16 have been even strength markers.
And he'll be Detroit's representative at the All-Star game.
They turn it over.
Aren't what you didn't want them to do. You know, when I was looking at this game, and I, you know, you're just seeing what you see. You say to yourself, okay, what did the Avalanche...
Back to the far point. Cale Makar walks the blue line. Near side, Rantanen. Rantanen down low, Landeskog. Back for Rantanen. Quickly back for Cale Makar. Shot through traffic. Nazem Kadri. And the Kadri man can. It's a power play goal. And this is a 1-1 hockey game.
The eyes away from Howard. Shoots that puck. Kadri tips it. And the Avalanche off a post and in.
As Jost working in the far corner gets it down low from Antniemo. Now Rantanen just off the bench. Back for Cale Makar. At the near side point, Makar escapes into the circle. Makar! Backdoor! Score! Makar to MacKinnon! And 2 points for Cale Makar.
Perfected that left-hand shot to the left of the goalie. Coming across on the forehand, chipping it back up and over.
Again, a free agent signing after a buyout by Dallas, Valeri Nichushkin. Played very, very well with his new club. 8 goals on assists. 4 points. And there's Rantanen, excuse me. It's Burakovsky backdoor for Nazem Kadri. And he now has one more than he had all of last year. Available for the return pass. And Detroit will lock it free. Jost through center ice. Picks up the puck in the near side circle behind the net. Jost spins away. Snow goes on. Jost in front. Score! This time it's Matt Nieto. And it's a 4-1 lead for the Avalanche.
Everyone moving forward. Tyson Jost, in my mind, he had the hat trick, but this is as good a game as he's had all round.
Allison Bowie into the zone. Return pass to the point. Nemeth will chop at it. Larkin in the corner. Shot is blocked by Ian Cole. Zadina. Kick loose. Puck just sitting there. Larkin has it. Nichushkin scores. Larkin is second point of the game. It's over the shoulder of Pavel Francouz. And it's a 2-goal lead for Colorado with under 13 to go in the period.
Well, Larkin, who is a, you know, he's just a good hockey player. You know, and right there.
Now some Kadri into the zone. Kadri down low for Burakovsky. Now far corner. Burakovsky pass near side for Graves. Shot. Score! Ryan Graves with an absolute cannon upstairs on Jimmy Howard. And the 3-goal lead is restored. It's 5-2 Colorado.
Wait, Graves.
No hats on the ice yet.
Graves is going to get a point here. He's going to get another plus as his...
I don't know.
Watch. This will be a real good angle right here. Graves' shot goes. Let's have up and in.
Like Maxwell Smart missed it by that. Will airmail it down ice for Colorado. It is a smaller booth. The radio booth. Larkin. Pass back door. Out in front. They score. A broken play. And Givani Smith gets one back for Detroit with 2:03 to go in the third period. It's 5-3 Avalanche.
Completely falling apart. They did not. They've kept coming. The Avalanche get a couple of goals here in this third, but they just have really pushed it.
That could be with a head coach as well as Howard. Why not? He'll leave. MacKinnon picks it up. Has a wide open net. MacKinnon looking, shooting. He scores. It's
puts the icing on the cake, and Nathan MacKinnon hits the 30-goal plateau. Three seasons in a row, and Nathan MacKinnon is a 30-goal scorer. And 1-1 versus the Eastern Conference as the crowd comes to its feet, and that looks the Avalanche win again.
You know what, a lot of their chances and goals were from us not coming back into our zone good enough, and we knew coming in that a team like this, we're going to have to defend a lot. They're three, four lines that have good players and can score, so we knew we were going to have to play a good defensive game, but I don't think we came back and sorted out enough. So we're going to have to look at that and be ready for Minnesota.
It was a solid first period.
Yeah, it was. You know what, they scored back-to-back there in the second, and then they scored back-to-back there in the third. And, we just didn't get enough in the second offensively, and there was a lot of power plays for them. But we just didn't get it going offensively in the second, and we didn't have enough shots. I thought in the first, I don't know what the shots were, but they were close, and they had a lot of power plays. So, from then on, after those two goals against, we got to find a way to get in the ozone and grind them down a little bit.
And he's missed minutes are increasing right now, and you've sung his praises before. What's going into that for him right now?
Simple game. He's not doing anything to cost us. He's impact with his size and physicality, and mixing it up. You saw him score again tonight. Goes to the net hard. He wins puck battles. So he has been a positive.
Can you tell Tyler's the type who relishes when fans boo him like they do here?
You know what, I think this rivalry, I got asked a couple days ago if it's still there. I think, with the fans, most definitely it's still there. And, next year, year after, and the years following with the players they have and the players that we have, it's going to be an exciting rivalry again. Tyler absolutely does. And he's a guy that, I can't wait for him to be in a playoff series with us and see what.
They're a team that wants to spend a lot of time in the offensive zone, and we needed to do a better job tonight of playing through bodies and eliminate their rush game and their offensive zone time. They're a team that likes to throw a lot of pucks in that, and they did exactly that.
You lost Mike Green. How did that impact things, especially in the third few
games? Well, it definitely impacts things when you lose a player his caliber. Greener's been steady for us in the back end all year, and when you lose a veteran presence like him out there, especially a guy that logs top minutes against top lines, it's tough, but it's a chance for everyone else to step up.
Multiple goals you guys give up so quickly. I mean, I don't know if there's a stat out there for it, but man, that's got to kill you guys.
It's killed us all season. In the second period, they get the power play goal there, a minute and a half or so in, and then nobody picked up MacKinnon coming off the bench. I looked twice, there was no one there, and so I was as surprised as everyone when Cal made the pass back.
Tuning on the power play, you had two whacks at it out there. How are you finding that role for yourself right now, getting that opportunity in that situation?
Pretty good. Like, that's where I'm going to score most of my goals right in front of the net. So the goalie made a good first save. I just tried to bang the rebound in. Didn't go in, but created a couple chances.
Givani, what's changed for you coming up this season? It looks like you're a lot more confident.
Just growing as a person, as a player, spending summers in Detroit and, working out, working with the puck, the skill coaches, and just, bringing that into the season.
Are you starting to see how using your size can be an advantage for you?
Yeah, absolutely. It's hard to create time and space out here, so when there's time that I can't use my body to make space, you can tell you got an extra second or two there.
The result is disappointing, but is it important for a team to show you still have fight in you, that, when it gets to be 5-2, you still don't just lay
absolutely.
Down?
Absolutely. That's where, adversity comes. Late in the period there, when I scored that goal, we had some jump. Larkin was going, Fabry was going hard to the net, and I just stopped the net. So, know, that's adversity we need, and, you know, it's carrying on for the future.
No, I thought in the second period we couldn't get out of our end. So then all of a sudden you're just spending a whole bunch of time defending. You get an out. They outchange just because of that. You can't get people on and off the ice. You know, so then you end up with some shifts that are a bit too long. We lost the forward right away, obviously, in Nielsen, and then we lost the second game in a row, and then we lost a D-man partway through that second, and it just taxed our guys a lot. It's just a whole bunch of defending, and all of a sudden we didn't have much of our skating legs, and that's a hard team to not have your skating legs against, whether it was off the rush or mainly showed in D-zone. We couldn't create any stalls at all. So if you can't create any stalls, you're chasing people around, and eventually you lose somebody, and it's in your net. We got to be way, way, way better in D-zone. But part of that, a huge part of that, is creating stalls, skating, closing on people, and creating stalls. We've got to be better at that.
Are you seeing Dylan really since the Christmas break, maybe he seems to really be asserting himself more? He talked about how his confidence had kind of sagged in the first half.
Yeah, you know, I think he's played pretty well since the break. I think his skating-wise, he's been better than maybe he had at the end. You know, when you start to lose confidence or the losses wear on you, it starts to hurt your energy a little bit. We've got to be real careful of that right now, to be honest with you. We've got to find a way to have great energy here in our last game before the break, and then get ourselves rejuvenated coming back out of the break. So, you know, I think Dylan's... he competes hard all the time. I've asked a lot of them here. We've lost sentiment the last two games. He played 24 minutes the other night. I haven't seen the report tonight, but I'm sure he played lots of minutes tonight. So I'm asking probably too much of him in terms of minutes, so we got to do a better job managing that. But I think he's playing really, really hard.
Just an example of stick-to-itness he showed. And as a team, getting two goals, like keeping pushing after they kind of took control.
Yeah, I thought, getting that goal, the second goal there, I mean, I thought we started to play a little bit. And, we've done a pretty good job of not playing the scoreboard and not playing the record and just keep playing. And certainly there's times where it crushes you a little bit. And, we will sag for a bit, but I think we're doing a way better job of continuing to grind through it.
Does it look like Howard's game is beginning to really round into shape the last three?
Howard was excellent tonight. I mean, he gave us a chance. I mean, we wouldn't have been in the game if he hadn't played as well as he had played. So he was excellent. He's been really good the last three games. He looks like he's on top of his game. I hate to see the backdoor goals because those are goals that eat away at a goalie's confidence. And we just got to make sure he understands we're going to do everything we can to correct that. He's just got to keep stopping the ones he's supposed to stop and not cheat and hope on the back door. You know, that's what happens sometimes. Got to get him rest tomorrow. I don't know if he'll skate or not. Got to get him some rest for sure because there were some hard games. The Florida game was hard. This game was hard in terms of being in your crouch a lot.